idiom show. It's time to cheer the fact with our idiomatically speaking crew. Welcome Nadia, Yvonne and Sandy.
Thanks Kylie and Stone the Crows. Have we got a story for you? Hot, hot, hot off the presses. You had better pull yourself together because I don't want you to get all bent out of shape and miss the boat with this one.
To make a long story short, what she's trying to say is that the kids at Cabramatta Public School are on the ball and have pulled their socks up to kill two birds with one stone by going back to the drawing board and putting their thinking caps on.
This could be a blessing in disguise. Here we are building the field.
Better late than ever, I say.
You may think they're barking up the wrong tree. But the picture is worth a thousand words.
Wrong tree.
Look at this.
Okay, so after watching that, what can you tell me about what a simile is? Tommy.
So, a simile is like something that compares to something, like about like a thing which compares to another thing makes a simile.
Oh, excellent. Mm-hmm. Excellent. So comparing one object to something else. Have you heard of any similes before? So one was two peas in a pod, or like two peas in a pod, sorry. Can you tell me about that?
Fast as a car.
A simile is comparing two things using the words like or as. So an example is, she was as delicate as a flower.
Over on the number one, we have Juliana was as tall as a tree. So what does that mean, as tall as a tree? Juliana. Yeah.
She's very tall.
Yes, so she's very tall. So it's describing her, comparing her to the height of a tree. Is she really as tall as a tree?
Are you pulling my leg? That doesn't look like rocket science. I thought it was going to be a case of pigs might fly. What did they do with that knowledge?
They did a joint construction, of course.
Very interesting. I'd give them an A for effort. What cool customers.
And they are writing independently.
Well, that's the end of our segment. We hope we haven't let the cat out of the bag too much. But hitting the nail on the head is what we do here. We are not known for cutting corners and letting people off the hook.
Well, easy does it. Before things get out of hand, we better give credit where credit is due and thank the kids from Cabramatta.
There's no point in crying over spilt milk or beating around the bush. It's time to bite the bullet and call it a day, because now we have bigger fish to fry. Who will we put to the test next time?
I hope it's not a wild goose chase. I'm tired just thinking about someone having to face the music. I think I'll hit the sack before I start to crack up.
Don't worry, it'll be a piece of cake. Keep your hair on and hang in there till next episode. We will leave no stone unturned and put another school through the ringer and give them the third degree too.
The end. Credits. Many thanks to 5E, 5G and 5S. And of course, Mr. Salos. And our presenters, Kylie, Sandy, Yovana, and Nadia.